As autumn deepens, Oriental storks set out from northeast China. The long journey is bound for the Delta wetland at the Yellow River's mouth. The Oriental stork is very picky about its habitat and feels the slightest change in it. Its presence in a wetland is a significant testimony to the excellence of local ecology. As the temperature drops, the stork stopping over around here should have headed south for wintering. But the abundance of food sources has changed the minds of some who still linger in the depth of winter. Each mature stork must fulfill the mission of procreation. Those who choose to stay need to build a high and secure nest. The Yellow River Delta is a fresh piece of wetland formed at the estuary. It offers few tall trees within sight for the storks to lay eggs in. The birds have to adapt. The steel frame between the poles offers the foundation for them to build on. The conservationists have saved the birds a lot of trouble with artificial nests. They have only to drop some branches into the bowl-shaped receptacle create a sturdy, affordable housing to snug in. When spring arrives, they mate and start a family. In a month, the chicks break out of the shells. To join the growing stork population that has settled in the wetland. The wetland has seen the birth of over 2,000 Oriental stork chicks. The Yellow River Delta has become the world's largest breeding ground for this species. And gained the honor of true land of Oriental storks.